had another question. I wanted to answer it with a quick video. They were talking about having hypoglycemia, low blood sugar, and every time they consume protein, they feel a lot better, okay? So they wanted to know why protein helps with hypoglycemia. Now, when I had low blood sugar issues, and by the way, what happens is when the blood sugar comes up, insulin will then push the blood sugar down and you can end up with lower blood sugar. And people with low blood sugar, a lot of times, have a higher amount of insulin in their body and it's pushing it down. And we don't have those counter hormones or counter regulatory hormones to kind of push it back up. So you end up with low blood sugar. And the symptoms are fatigue, dizziness, irritableness, grouchy, dry eyes, depression. There's all these different symptoms. I remember having hypoglycemia really bad and I had really dry, irritated eyes. Then I started consuming protein and I felt great for years. But getting back to the video, some people have this idea that the fuel that the body uses is either glucose, sugar, or fat, or ketones. But protein can be used as a fuel. Protein can be broken down in the body into what's called carbon skeletons. And that can actually be converted into glucose, okay? And the term is gluconeogenesis. So your body can make fuel, glucose, from protein. So protein can act as a fuel in addition to replacing your protein in your body. So it's not just fat and glucose. You can get energy from protein. And this is why when you consume protein, when you have low blood sugar, you actually start feeling better. Now, if you were to consume a carbohydrate when you had hypoglycemia, you would feel better for maybe a minute or two, but then the insulin's going to kick it back down here. Now, what's unique about consuming protein is that, yes, you are going to stimulate some insulin, especially if you're consuming a lot of protein, but you're also going to stimulate at the same time glucagon. Glucagon is the opposing hormone to insulin. It's made by the pancreas as well. And glucagon will raise the blood sugar and insulin will lower it. So it'll create a nice leveling effect right here when you consume protein. So protein is a glucogenic precursor. So it's actually a building block that can be turned into glucose if your body needs to do that. Now, this video is not just to have people start consuming a lot of protein. I recommend doing a moderate amount of protein. It's just to help you understand why you're going to feel better if you consume protein if you have hypoglycemia. The ultimate solution for hypoglycemia is to get on a healthy ketogenic diet, do the whole program, and intermittent fasting, because that way you will correct this large amount of insulin that is really behind this problem in the first place. And that's coming from insulin resistance. And once this is corrected, you won't have the highs and lows anymore. So the need to fix anything related to hypoglycemia is not there anymore. So your blood sugars may even come down to 70 or even 60, but you don't get those symptoms anymore. You feel very, very stable. So if you have hypoglycemia, I put several videos on this page so you can get more data. Thanks for watching.